everybody. Along with Eddie Olchek, I'm Mike Emmerich. The people behind us have paid the price of admission to watch a lot of things in a hockey game, but one thrilling part of it is scoring goals. And we have a guy that's done it the best.
Not easy to score goals, Doc, and when he's on the ice, you better be aware because he's got the opportunity and the ability to put the puck in the back of the net. Doug Dass has been filling the net all season long, and he's been scoring goals in a lot of different ways. He's very tough to defend when he's on the ice.
And now we turn to the last lines of defense, the goalies. Luongo's the guardian of the crease tonight for the Panthers. This is a season you dream about if you're a goalie. Notice the numbers, and then let's just watch him play. Coaching staff remains confident in this guy. He won the last game. Two teams chomping at the bit. Let's get going. Barkov's a good face-off man. Ready for the Panthers. Galchenyuk's out there to try to beat him for the Coyotes. And we have just begun.
Florida's looking to get a roll going with another win tonight. Hard work and consistency will allow them to do that.
What a hit that was!
Well, there's no surprise there, Doc. We expected a physical game. The contest will be aggressive from start to finish. There's an early hit to set the tone.
One-time blast. Terrific save. He scores! That's a great start at breaking through. 1-0. We knew the scoreless tie would be broken. Who thought this early? And by the visitor.
Boy, the visitor's got to gain a lot of confidence getting this early lead.
The Panthers win the draw. What's next? Let's it go. Great save. Play stopped. That puck is just held.
The Panthers want to be an aggressive team, and this player has among the highest hit totals in the league. Sometimes I wonder if he even looks at the puck. The Coyotes are only half of the group in this game that has played very well over the last 10 games. Both of these teams have played almost identically. Their records are almost identical as they head into this matchup.
Back to the point. Corral puts one on. Use that big goalie stick well. Can start the attack going in the zone. Skill play by Ekman Larson. Arizona's in the neutral zone along the wing. Taken out along the boards.
Love the physical play. He takes his man right into the boards with a solid hit.
Shoots. Great point blank save.
Now that's a timely save. A beautiful one.
Just over 6 minutes gone. Arizona's ahead, 1-0. Directing that one to Huberdeau. Brings it in for an attack. Gives it over to the point. Propelled to Matheson. Takes that pass from the other point. Tries to get it on net, and a save. Right on his stick, can he get it out? And the penalty killers come up big again, it's cleared.
Power play, huh? Okay.
Laid on to Dvorak. Good chance, denied. Dundas is hooked, and there will be a penalty call. Florida's got their man over on the delayed call, and the goalie rests at the bench. Shot! He wore that puck on a hard shot. The Coyotes guilty of a minor penalty for using the stick blade. Just a hook.
Well, what he was trying to do is try to get the puck, but unfortunately for him, he reached in and hooked around the player. Off to the penalty box he goes.
Florida's power play will get lots of space out there. A 5-on-3.
You don't get too many chances like this, Doc. A 5-on-3 power play. The key is to be aggressive. Get the puck to the net. Make those three penalty killers move all over the place.
Got in front of another one.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
Save. He froze that just for a break.
Florida Islanders had an aggressive mindset throughout these last 10 games. They've forechecked extremely well. They've been aggressive and on the body. We'll see if they can impose their will on their opponent, who's played much the same way over their last 10.
Galchenyuk's getting a minor for slashing.
Oh, look at the reaction of the puck carrier. He is in some pain. That's a slash.
Florida special teams have been special. Let's see if they come up big here. It's a two-man advantage, and it's not short.
This 5-on-3 power play has to be careful that they don't get lulled into a sense of security here, and they move the puck around the outside and never challenge the penalty killers.
Florida's got it. Take it to the slot. Point blank save.
He had his eye on the puck the whole time. What a stop.
Dundas takes a slash here. There'll be a penalty. Whistle is blown. Penalty called. And the penalty box door swings open. Ekman Larson's getting a penalty for slashing. It's 2 minutes.
Oh, that's a blatant slash, Doc. Anytime that you slide your bottom hand up your stick and swing your stick, you're going to the box.
The Panthers get a huge opportunity here. It's a two-man advantage, and it's a long one.
This is
huge. Let's see how they do.
One of the biggest mistakes a 5-on-3 power play makes is they're looking for the perfect shot. The more you shoot it, the more you move the penalty killers around, and you start to tire them out.
Puck is thrown to Dundas. Snapping a pass to Huberdeau. That's the way to make him pay.
Right over top of him in the middle of the ice. That is a great hit.
Save there. Fires! Routine save.
Arizona's getting some great goaltending early in this game. It doesn't get any bigger or better than this. What a big-time save. See if this will spark their offense.
What a sparklers. What a sparklers. Now we got one back.
Here in the first. Only a pair of goals so far, equally divided. Let's a shot fly. Wonderful stop. And the referee's whistle.
We got a few snacks back.
Well, with all my years involved in a game, I would anticipate there's going to be a little bit of payback after that big open ice hit.
Florida's power play is set up with several one-time options for them. That really makes them difficult to contend with. As a result, they're among the league's very best.
Shot it back out of his own end. Florida's leading through mid-ice. A heartening collision. You thought they were gone. They're not. Connaughton's got it on his stick, trying to clear.
Fuckers.
Smart recovery by Yandel. Pitching it to Barkov. Leads that charge into the zone. Lightning-like reflexes there. Great glove save. The tie-up. He needed help, and he got it. That one slung back out, and so there's still some more time left on the power play. Passing one off now to Huberdeau. Fires! Puck ricocheted off the screen. Didn't get any of it. The Panthers' power play is over. They've had their problems tonight. Pajarvi slashed. Ooh, that's going to be a penalty. Skates it into the zone. Goalie to the bench. Extra attacker out. The Panthers have taken a slashing minor here.
2 minutes for slashing. Under the penalty. 12 minutes, 5 seconds.
Flings it. Terrific shot, but a denial. Able to attack now. Oh, a close call there.
We sometimes forget the speeds these guys are playing at, but accuracy is a key in creating chances.
From his own end on the power play, it's taken. Wow, that's got to be a call. That's got to be a penalty. And that's got to be an answer from the other team. Now it's directed to Perlini. Is able to move on in. Fires. That went off the pad. Goaltender pass. Brought ahead. Florida's cleared. A lot of work, but penalty time less and less now. Looking to Strome. Arizona's along the wing at center ice. Takes that pass. That puck hit him on the way to the net. It's out of the zone. Arizona seeing the penalty. He won't avoid something for doing that. A hit that can make you mad.
Ekman Larson's not going to be too happy with that. He didn't have his head up, wasn't aware of everybody around him, and then he got steamrolled. Not sure who made the hit, but that is a big one.
A little under 6 minutes to go in the period. Florida's got a lead, but it's just 2-1. Clean win on the draw. Florida's penalty kill comes through. Now we're back even.
Well, they had a couple of really good chances there, but weren't able to cash in. And so Fuck. Now that the power play is over, they find themselves trailing by one yet again.
No pepperonis.
Talbot's made a textbook stop here. He's in good shape positionally. He makes the save, and he makes it look really easy.
Almost. Almost we got the crackers, boys. Oh, we are winning. Oh, really? How that happened? We are winning. Oh, I didn't realize we are winning. Well, yeah.
Florida's power play has been one of their weak points. It's near the bottom third of the league on a consistent basis. They don't rush the puck into the zone with any urgency, and as a result, very little time set up in the offensive zone.
With a shot. Great save. And decides to just hold on and get a stoppage of play.
Hey, Pucho.
The Coyotes talk about their mantra of blocking shots. Well, over the last few games, it's remarkable.
A brilliant save at the horn. The first period has come to an end, and both teams got a little confidence out of this. Hockey's narrowest lead is what we have here. One goal. There are two periods to go, and that's a good thing for at least one team. Overwhelmed in the shots on goal totals in that period. 25 for the Panthers and 15 for the Coyotes. The Panthers are holding on to a lead, and it's saves like this one that have kept them there. We'll be right back.
What a nice game.
Eddie, we're about to enter the second period here. What did you think of the opening period of our game?
What a nasty
Arizona's
game.
Arizona's team is still in this game, Doc.
We think this game is nasty.
Goal, but easily could be a lot more. You hear the term now, puck management. They did not manage the puck at all in that first period. Pitching this one to Simmons. On to Galchenyuk. Got it in his own end. And he holds on.
Yeah,
and
fuck it.
The Coyotes win the draw. Using the point, he's got it. That puck was a. Oh, what a mean, mean hit that one was.
Oh, shit.
That's probably going to bring an answer. The Panthers get two for boarding.
These are the type of plays, Doc, that we want to eliminate from the game where the attacking player has no chance to protect himself when getting hit from behind.
The Coyotes get another power play chance here. Let's see what happens this time.
This power play cannot worry about the shorthanded goals they gave up earlier.
No matter how often you work on the power play, the ones that struggle go back to the same basic tenets. And it's to simplify things. Get it to the point, shoot it, get traffic, retrieve it, shoot it again.
And holds on to that puck to get the whistle.
Simplify our game, gentlemen.
Shooter was shooting for a rebound. At least I hope he was, because that shot had no chance of going in.
A couple of big hits. Good. Very good. Nice, good old-fashioned big hitter. 1 second, and we're good.
Solid, clean win. The Coyotes' power play let them down at a key point.
They had all kinds of zone time. Really, they didn't leave the zone much at all. But they didn't get the puck into the middle
what
of the
fuck,
end.
What the
fuck, yeah? Didn't have any traffic in front of the net.
Really?
The penalty killers were content to let them pass it around the outside.
Is Ekblad again?
He's making like Paul Bunyan out there. That's a two-minute slash.
Shit. Hey, it's him again.
Power play is too
the big boy's there.
Find a way to change it up.
Absolutely. I think you're right, Eddie. Let's see what the team does here.
Florida's gotten it back out. They check the clock, get ready to defend.
Chip to Galchenyuk.
Stick to Zahn. Good job in clearing it out of his own end. Trying to get it back out of the zone. That puck didn't get out, and the power play continues. Slid to Giordano. Moving it to Trocheck. Cleared it out of there. The Coyotes will play it from their own end on this power play. Steps across that line. A shot. That was a great play and goal.
Now that's a beautiful stop on a great scoring chance.
The bench can switch now following that clear.
Pass attempt to Galchenyuk. Trying to go to Simmons.
I'd like to say that I think this game is going to open up and there's going to be all kinds of chances all over the place. But both teams have really adopted a never give an inch style of play. I think this is tight checking right down to the final horn.
Directing that one to Dundas.
Offside. If no team would end for every action, there's a reaction.
When you make a play like that, usually the end result is this.
And out of all of this, both receive fighting majors.
Or you can feel the energy down here by the home benches. Their guys are up on their feet as they know their boy has won this fight. Chychrun's headed directly down the tunnel after that fight. He's not going to the penalty box. He's going to go get some physical attention.
Puck is thrown to Huberdeau. Florida's got it and moving up the wing. Skill play by Demers. Takes that pass. Here we go. Turned away with the stick.
Look.
Gains the zone. A shot. Outstanding point blank save.
Great display of goaltending right there, Doc.
Snapping a pass to Huberdeau.
Sends to the point. And he hatchets one. Bad save. Ooh, hard one there. Shoots off the mark.
He can't miss by a much smaller margin than that. He rifled it just wide of the net.
Shit.
Let's it go. Save. And ring more bells on that one. One after another. Can he clear the zone?
Everyone got his responsibilities.
And two periods in the books, one more to go, but a rest comes first. Through two periods, here are the shots on goal. Get ready. 34 for Florida and 24 for the Coyotes. His team is behind. It would be further behind if not for big saves like this one. Intermission is next. At least 20 minutes to go. What are your thoughts so far?
Arizona's coaching staff, Doc, has to be pretty pleased the way they played through the first 40 minutes of play. One area of concern has been their offense. They need to take advantage of all the time of possession and finally put the puck into the back of the net.
Pitching it to Dundas. The Panthers with possession in the defensive zone.
Hammers one, glove. Puck covered, whistle blown.
Dundas adds to his stratospheric penalty total again. He's going to go sit. This is a skate that he's very familiar with.
No, I'm not.
The faceoff, the tie-up, and a solid job from the winger there.
Just a good rub out there. He kicked it along out of the scrum. The Coyotes with a neutral zone possession along the wing. He takes that point pass. Propelled to Ekman Larson. Wrist shot. Block. Just couldn't make it.
I've seen this coming from the Yotes. They've had all the pressure on.
He's got it there. He wants to clear it out. Picked up by the defense. Driving in from no man's land. Let's a shot go.
Holy fucker macaroni, man.
It is much better to give than receive. Trust me.
Florida's got a little bit of swagger going now. Their man's won the fight. The crowd is ecstatic.
That was...
Passing one off now to Barkov. Outmaneuvers his man in the zone. Outstanding save. Holy, a great chance. Flings it. The shot is off.
That's what I would call a grade A scoring chance, but the shot just missed the target.
The Panthers lug the puck in their own end. Into the attacking end. What a terrific save. And he gains the zone. Right to the point. Here it comes. Ekblad's got it on his stick, trying to get it out of there. Good keep at the line. More attack coming. Good work there in goal. Going out on the road for any length of time is hard in this league, but that's the challenge these guys face, and the best teams find a way to win at home and on the road.
The Panthers do an excellent job limiting their opponent's shots on net. One of the main reasons is how many shots they block. Over the last few games, it's a crazy number.
Good place to shoot from, and he does. The Panthers are at the wing in neutral ice. Takes a shot and a save. Hangs on to that one for a stoppage in play.
Florida's been an offensive juggernaut, led by this player who has among the highest points totals in the league. He's a dangerous player, remarkably skilled on the power play.
The Panthers get the draw. What a ripper! A lightning-like glove. He cut that one off in the defensive end.
Shit.
Laid on to Perlini. Save! Both of them got all of that one. The horn signals the end of the game. The clock at zeros. The Coyotes lose big.
Boy, not a good effort at all, especially in that third period.
Not back-checking leg of fuckers. We lost like 50. Shot blocking is up. Okay. Well, we got some nice touches. No.
The dynasty teams of the 80s filled the rafters with championship banners. But tonight's Oilers squad will try to leave their own mark here in Edmonton.
Greetings, everyone. With Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro coming up in just a moment. I'm Mike Emmerich. It's the end of a long homestand, and it hasn't been very good, but it's finally coming to an end. How do you approach this last game?
Well, I think it's pretty simple, Doc, is that the mindset at home tonight to end this homestand should be the same way that you approach road games. Nothing fancy. Keep it simple and worry about what you can and bring the hard hats here at home that you would bring on the road.
Edmonton's obviously not happy with the way they performed during this homestand, but I got the sense of talking to some of the players and coaches this morning at the pregame skate is that they're going to come out with a real simple attitude, a real simple game plan. Pucks ahead, people ahead, put the hard hats on and see what happens at the end of 60 or maybe even longer minutes of this game.
And now we turn to the last lines of defense, the goalies. A shutout last time? Of course he's in there this time. No surprise he's starting this game. He won the last one. The referee has checked. The goal lights work. Let's see if anybody can light them.
McDavid's the faceoff man for Edmonton. Barkov's out there to try to beat him for the Panthers. He throws it there. Save there. Play stops, so I turn to Eddie, and he points to Ray. You're on, man.
Montoya's had an excellent season so far. He's got a high winning percentage, way more wins than losses. He's made enough saves that gives his team a chance to get their feet underneath him when they don't play very well. But he's been pretty consistent this year. We'll see if the opposition can get somebody in his eyes tonight, make it difficult for him to see the puck.
Many thanks, Ray. The Oilers hopefully shifting from defense to offense in their own end.
Skates it into the zone. Taken over again. Now it's directed to Ekblad. Chip to Dundas. Cranks one. Save!
Look at how active the goaltender is looking around the screen to try to make the stop.
A collision!
Doc, no surprise there. We expected a physical game, and we're going to get one. That early hit is just an example of what we're going to see.
Slid to Dundas. Snapping a pass to Puljujarvi. Edmonton's carrying on through the neutral zone.
Montoya's shutout streak continues with every minute that runs by on the clock. He had a shutout in his last game, and he'd like to pile up a few more minutes here.
Edmonton's won that faceoff. They have it. Picks it up in his own end. Pass attempt to Girardi. Barkov slashed, and the arm of the referee is up. A penalty will be coming. Reeder's getting a penalty for slashing. It's 2 minutes.
Oh, that's a blatant slash, Doc. Any time that you slide your bottom hand up your stick and swing your stick, you're going to the box.
The Panthers are going to get their first opportunity on the power play right now.
Well, this is a great chance for them. The game's initial power play. A first chance to get on the board.
The Oilers start the rush up ice. It's dumped in. Springs it ahead to Huberdeau. Using the point, he's got it. Cut that pass in his own end. Right in front. That's a good solid hit. He'll feel that one.
Oh, that hit sends a message.
Gathered up again by Yandel. In with it now. Wonderful block. Oh, what a hit that one was.
Good thing he's wearing the helmet. That could have been very dangerous.
He's got that pass at the point. Did what he's paid to do. To Strom. Puck is thrown to Cassian. He loads it up. What a save! I was looking for the light to come on. Driving in from no man's land. and thrown down to Huberdeau. Shoots one. He wore that puck on a hard shot. He's got it. Florida's up the wing, setting things up. Shoots it on. Great save. Makes the stop and holds for the whistle. Clean win on the draw. Trying to go to Strom. Laid on to Kajula. Gives it over to the point. Shoots. They score!
Oh, how's that, Hunch? Shit.
Now that the scoring's been opened up, we'll see if the opponent can punch their way back into this game. You can't be back at your heels too long.
Shit.
The Oilers have gotten the first goal of the game. Perhaps they can carry that off the ice with them.
Shit. Is it Zelly online?
Everything old is new again.
The Carriera.
One period played. Carriera. The second period is about to begin. What do you think of what we've seen so far?
Florida's lucky to still be in this game after the first period. They had turnover after turnover. I'm sure the coaches addressed that problem in the intermission.
Up to the point. With geometry, it's on to Barkov. One-time blast. Perfect save. Tires. Got in the way of that one. Score! They're back to within one.
Okay. There's an alley. This is oil country. It is.
He's played so well for the entirety of this streak. Eventually, a puck's gonna get past you. Now we'll see if he can rebound and start a new one.
The Panthers, with the scoring of that goal, have cut the lead in half and still an entire period to play. The Oilers control from the faceoff.
By number 25, assisted by number 11, Jonathan Huberdeau.
Nice work by Huberdeau. Carries it on in from center. Oh, what a club he's got there.
Shit.
Florida's lucky to have one of the top goal scorers in the league. He's a dangerous player that seems to be able to score no matter what the fact that he's the other team's focus.
Edmonton's got a face-off win. Looking to Klefbom. Pitching it to McDavid. In the slot. Oh, pad stop on the redirect. On to Dundas. Takes it in from the neutral zone. He missed the net.
The goalie didn't even move. That thing was way wider than that.
Things are heating up with that hit.
I wonder if that hit will change the momentum of this game.
Did not go very well that time. Loose puck. Great save, point blank.
Great display of goaltending right there, Doc.
The Oilers usually have a power play advantage, but they won't tonight, as their opponent has every bit as good a power play as they do. The real key will be who can limit the number of times they're shorthanded.
Oh, what a hit. That slowed things down.
That's a great hit. He thought he had more room to get down the wall, and he got closed off in a hurry.
The Oilers with possession up the wing. Propelled to Strome. Terrific shot, but a save. He's got that point pass. Big pad save.
Florida's physical play opens up the ice for them all over the place. This player has among the highest hit totals in the league. Very valuable although he's not a big scorer.
A little over 8 minutes to go here in the second. They have scored, and so maybe there's momentum here. Perfect tip by the stick. The Panthers shoot it back out. Got some time to check the clock and prepare to defend again. Directing that one to Puljujarvi. To the point it comes. Fires! May not have been intentional, but he got it anyway. Oh, great save there. Not much room to work, but he got a good shot away.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
Florida's killed off a penalty, and so we're back at full strength.
Well, that penalty-killing group was like a well-oiled machine. They moved at the right time, they worked in sync, and the goaltender made any saves that he had to.
To McDavid. Passing one off now to Puljujarvi. Brings it in for an attack. Has it in his own end.
I'm generally a guy that's entertained by lots of goals, and low-scoring games kind of bore me, but this has been pretty good. There's been chances, the goaltenders have been good, and it's been very physical.
That was a great play and goal. And yet another save. How does he do that? There's a hooking call on this play, but he keeps going.
Jesus.
The Panthers are given a
Jesus Lord. No nič, to sme dostali do nosa.
To
je klasický nosal.
So, as we think back through the first two, we think ahead toward the third. Third period about to begin. What did you think of the second?
Florida's down after the first 40 minutes of play. Couple of positives. One, they're only down
couple of touches.
Second, time of possession has been in their favor, but at some point they have to convert some of those chances.
Shit.
The Oilers skated up on the side. Great job in his own end with that interception. That puck hit him on the way to the net. Hammers one. Save, but just barely. Outstanding body contact.
I like that he's trying to create space by throwing the body around. This is a way to change momentum in a hockey game.
Good intercept in his own end. Moving it to Matheson. Florida's along the wing at center ice. Fires. Save. Hangs on to that one for a stoppage in play. A little under 8 minutes have gone by, and it is 2-1 the score in this one. The Panthers have the puck at center ice. And he picks it up. And he dumps it in. Pitching this one to Dundas. Mm-hmm. Can't start the attack going in the zone. Save! Big drive! And ring more bells on that one. One after another.
Amazing reaction.
Dundas has among the highest total points in the league. His opponents are going to want to get up in his face, take away his space on the ice, so he can't maneuver so creatively.
Takes that pass from the other point. Lets it go. Score! And the game is even.
Came into the game, guys, thinking these teams were evenly matched. Now we've played some of this contest, and here we are back at a stalemate.
The Panthers have tied this game, so now we have a wonderful finish in store. Or maybe overtime. Or
nice
maybe
touch.
A shootout.
Nice touch.
Gives it on a cross from the point. Shot on goal. Terrific save. Terrific opportunity.
Seems like he was in too tight on the goaltender.
9 minutes, 56 seconds.
Gains the blue line. Sails it. A diving shot block. Shot. Terrific hit that time. It's just one of a pile he's had today. Edmonton's looking to head man up the wing. Now it's directed to Pizzik. Snapping a pass to Huberdeau. And the whistle. No team worth its name is going to let that go. They weren't going to let this one go through the rest of the game without settling it this way. And this fight on that punch has ended.
That's got to hurt. What a way to leave your mark.
Much safer up here with you, Doc, in the booth. 5 minutes for fighting for those guys.
Well. Under 3 minutes remaining in the period. A hockey game is a game of lead changes. This one now is even. A tremendous back and forth through three periods. Perhaps a decision will come in sudden death overtime. Dunda's goal has sent us to overtime, and that period will begin in just a moment.
Just $10. Make sure to stop off at any team store here at the arena. Pick up your specially priced item of the game. Our scarf tonight is just $10. Hurry, and supplies are limited.
Lynch.
We have begun sudden death overtime. Nobody scores, somebody will in a shootout. Brings a shot. Score! And the overtime is finished. And that's the end of the game. Well played. Edmonton's performance was terrific, but they have lost in sudden death. Something to build on moving forward. Some nights are special in memory. This one was an outstanding game. So long for now. From Orange County, California, best known for its world-famous theme park, the Ducks are on home ice in Anaheim. Hello, everyone. Along with Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro coming up in just a moment. I'm Mike Emery. Tonight, we have one of the top point getters in the league. He leads the entire league in assists, and oftentimes that whole stat gets left behind. It's pretty important.
It is, and especially the guys that play with him, Doc. It's not just necessarily the guy that handles the puck, but it's the players without it. Those guys shooting into those holes, opening up space. But, I mean, this particular player has great vision. He has great ice awareness. And he knows certainly where to put the puck on the tape in the offensive zone.
Barkov looking to add to his lead and assist. I assume he's going to face the top defenders on the other side, so his playmaking skill will be put to the test tonight.
Let's look at the starting netminders. John Gibson gets the start. Native of Pittsburgh was only 20 when he broke into the NHL in the Stanley Cup playoffs with the Ducks. Like a lot of goalies, good size, 6'3", 210. James Reimer began his professional career with a championship as a goaltender with the South Carolina Stingrays of the ECHL. He contributed 4 of their playoff victories nearly a decade ago. Ryan Getzlaf, Stanley Cup champion in Anaheim, captain of the team beginning in 2010, 2-time Olympic gold medalist for Canada. Oh, what a hit that one was!
Doc, no surprise there. We expected a physical game, and we're going to get one. That early hit is just an example of what we're going to see.
Shot, great save at the edge of the crease.
That great save was all positioning.
Let's go down near the ice for Ray.
It's like a little trailer to a movie when you watch East vs. West. You get a little bit of what could be a smorgasbord, which is the Stanley Cup Final.
Many thanks, Ray. Critical win of the draw. Perfect receipt of the pass. Point blank save. Oh, what a collision in open ice.
When you have the puck there, you're a marked man.
Terrific determination by Huberdeau. Big drive. Great save. Anaheim's heading up the neutral zone. Not a hard hit, but effective. It's lost. And he steps in. Able to hold on behind the cage. And he holds on and stops play. Just a hair under 4 minutes have passed. No goals to report yet. Puck drop, face off one, and the winger stepped right in. Brings it in for an attack. Rister, score! Didn't take too long, 1-0.
Try and get another. Push them back on their heels. They've got one. Go get two.
The Ducks have broken the tie. Perhaps they can build on this lead here in the first period. And they've taken that faceoff between the blue lines and won it.
Assisted by number 14, Adam Henry. Time of the goal. 4 minutes, 27 seconds.
Propelled to Pominville. He's got it. Steps across that line. Great glove save. Puck dropped, and the winger stepped in to help. That's big. Moving it to Getzlaf. Passing one off now to Ekblad. Puck is thrown to Huberdeau. Can start the attack going in the zone. Gloved. And the referee's whistle has stopped play.
Florida's physical play opens up the ice for them all over the place. This player has among the highest hit totals in the league. Very valuable, although he's not a big scorer.
The Ducks with a clean win on the draw. Nice pass up the wing to Richie. Directing that one to Barkov.
Enormous hit. He's crushed.
Getzlaf's often been talked about as a 200-foot player. That means using your body than just trying to get yourself around the ice with your skill.
Motors along up center.
Tremendous hit.
Better tighten up the brain bucket. Not afraid to get physical here tonight.
And down to Perry. To the point it comes. Richie's flashed. Ooh, that's going to be a penalty. Whistle is blown. And the guilty party heads off the ice. The Panthers have taken a slashing minor here.
Back in the era of wood sticks, this would really hurt. That's a slash.
The Ducks will send out their power play unit for the first time.
Just because it's your power play doesn't mean you can take a nap here. You have to work hard and continue to generate chances.
Looking to get it out. Cleared it out of there. The Ducks' power play will reset. Carries it on in from center. With a shot. Wonderful stop. And decides to just hold on and get a stoppage of play. Inside the final minute of the period. Laid on to Bertrano. And now we'll get the penalty call. Florida's two-minute penalty is for shooting the puck over the glass. Delay of game.
Anytime you shoot the puck from your defensive zone out into the crowd without touching anybody, it's a delay of game.
Anaheim special teams have been special. Let's see if they come up big here. It's a two-man advantage, and it's not short.
You're right, Doc. This is a big advantage here. A 5-on-3 on the power play. It's one you have to capitalize on.
The shot blocked. Terrific save. Terrific opportunity.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
If they can get organized, maybe time for one more attack before the end of the period. And they are in. He gets through. Handled with the stick. Muscled right off him. That one's cleared away, and that will take care of this period. 20 minutes in the books and a lot more hockey to be played. Both teams have connected one time. 1-1 after one.
Now's your chance to play.
Good job.
Join us in our arena as the first sports and entertainment facility.
The Panthers are getting a tremendous performance in goal tonight, even though offensively they haven't been strong. He's kept them in here, and here's one example. We'll return after these
words.
For joining us in a campaign to save energy and keep our city clean.
Good job.
period begins with a power play underway. Flings it. Say. Good clear that time, and so the power play unit will have to recoil. The Panthers get a minor penalty for delay of game.
That's a very frustrating penalty, Doc, for everybody. The player did not mean to shoot the puck out of the rink.
The Ducks get a huge opportunity here. It's a two-man advantage, and it's a long one. Let's see how they
do. You don't get too many chances like this, Doc. A five-on-three power play. The key is to be aggressive, get the puck to the net, make those three penalty killers move all over the place.
Ooh, a dangerous play made by the goaltender, but he's got it. They must retreat and start back again. He holds that one, and it's a good thing because they were buzzing.
Gibson's quick thinking allowed him to stop the play to slow down the pressure.
Wow, this looked like it was going in for sure, but he was able to make the save on that puck that changed directions.
All right, Matt.
Critical face-off win at that point. Takes that pass in the corner. Stands him up. The power play unit has to recoil and try yet again. He got corked on that one. That's several times tonight he's been hit. Has it picked up. Anaheim setting up an offense from the wing. Good, solid defensive play with the stick. Have us back at full strength because the penalty has been killed.
Outside of scoring, I don't know how that power play could have been much better, guys. They pounded the puck at the net, had lots of traffic, just couldn't score.
Lots of pressure right now. They've got to break that. Into the end of attack. Back on his stick. Outstanding body contact.
I wonder if that hit will change the momentum of this game.
He throws it there. You can score! The Ducks are ahead by one. They've been wheeling that puck to the net a lot.
Fuck's sake.
I'd like to say that I think this game is going to open up and there's going to be all kinds of chances all over the place, but both teams have really adopted a never-give-an-inch style of play. I think this is tight checking right down to the final point.
And decides to just cover it up and get the whistle. Just over 6 minutes have elapsed here in the second. We've got a leader in this game now. Maybe it'll be tied up again, though. A superb hit. A great hockey play there.
I saw that play coming from a mile away.
Waffle boarding. Pitching this one to Hoffman. Ooh, he loses it. He tried to do too much. Snapping a pass to Raquel. Okay, they win the draw. Sends to the point. A howitzer. No! Gotta get it on net.
You give him time and space, and he's gonna let that shot fly.
Throws it to Barkov. Back to the blue line to Yandle. Goes for it. Gets it with the blocker. That shot hit a man.
Kessler's nicked up here, but he can't get off the ice. He's gonna have to wobble around and finish this shift.
Panthers have a manpower advantage still and begin from their own end. Let's it go. Saved there. Holds on and gets the whistle.
Kessler's displaying some courage after being banged up earlier in the shift. He still gets himself into the shooting lane to block the shot.
Win. Chalk up one more. It's cleared back, and this forces a recoil. Panthers win it. Puts one on. Great save. Trying to get rid of that puck. Oh, that's a good keep. That's a great keep at the line. Lifts a little pass to the opposite corner.
The first part of this power play has been a disaster. They haven't been able to get into the zone at all, get set up, and get pucks to the net.
Outstanding point-blank save.
Now that's a timely save. A beautiful one.
He wore that puck on a hard shot. Good keep at the line. More attack coming. They've got all the gunners out. Tries to clear.
Fuck.
And that one cleared by the penalty killers. Smart recovery by Pizzi. Now it's directed to Barkov. Gains the zone. The Panthers' power play let them down at a key point.
Well, that was a great chance to tie the game, and they weren't able to find the equalizer. So now the players coming off the ice are frustrated. The coaches are frustrated.
Problem is, he put Reimer. Reimer in the goalie is a goal.
Long pass out of the zone on the wing. He's got it. Gives it over to the point. Slid to Huberdeau. Outlet up the middle to Dundas. Quick wrister and a save. Makes the stop and holds.
Che puccio.
Check in at ice level with Ray.
Kessler's been missing from the bench for quite some time. Just heard that he will not be back today. Guys.
Anaheim's got a face-off win. And he dumps it in. And they've got it again. Pitching it to Barkov. A point hammer shot. Just got it at the last moment. A slot wrister. And yet another save. How does he do that?
These saves are all about position.
Collected by Dan Girardi. And he steps across the line. Fires. Really quick grab.
In the second period.
Nice work with the stick. Poked it right away. Looking to Richie. The Ducks skated up on the side. Nice play with the stick. Nothing more will come. A shot. Oh, what a stop.
Che puccio. Cioè.
40 minutes have been played. Some hits given, some shots fired. But let's see what they have in mind as we get closer to the start of the third period and crunch time. Two periods have played, a busy time on the shot board. 23 for Anaheim and 20 for the Panthers. The Panthers are being held in this game by their goaltender. It would be decisively against them without him. Here's an example of his work as we go to break.
For supporting minor league hockey in your community.
Reimer je obyčajná pukovina.
Both teams have found the back of the net, but it's even. Underway here in the third. A shot. That shot came from right in front.
Now that's a beautiful stop on a great scoring chance.
Big drive. Missed the net.
Wicked shot there, Doc.
Richie's tripped up. That should be a penalty. Ekblad's going to the box.
Shit.
A player hit the ice, and the call on them is tripping. Anaheim's
this
power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet.
You're not going to get an endless supply of power plays, but they get another one here.
Definition of bad.
Anaheim setting things up in the defensive zone. On to Perry. Steps in from the neutral zone. A big one-timer, a textbook stick save.
Definition of bad. Reimer in the goalie, Classico.
Over 4 minutes have been played. Both teams have connected twice. Marvelous defensive play. What a gem that was. Zone to zone to Dundas. Flings it. Wonderful stop. The battling continues along the boards.
reads the play. Fuck, I should go.
Crosses that line. A one-timer, great glove save.
Fuck's sake, I should go.
Gibson's gonna be able to make that save all day. His positioning is perfect. It's not a difficult scoring chance.
Anaheim's quick on the draw. Oh, here's a wrister. His cage is rattling.
That's what we call a purpose shot.
Fires. Got a piece of that one. Takes that pass. A long scorcher. That puck was obstructed by a screen.
Trying to go to Kasha.
In with it now. Shoots one. What a save, considering the shooter that's usually in. Florida's got it again. A howitzer! A lightning-like glove. Cleared it back out of there. Good defensive play. Hand
on. It was actually good aim, but...
Terrific interception.
Boy, it got toasty.
Let's it go. A tremendous...
Holy shit, that was...
Cranks a blast! Save! Anaheim's good with that penalty kill, so we're back in full
close.
Well, that last power play wasn't very good, guys. Earlier in the game, they were pretty
really close.
They the puck well, and they were able to cash in. But this last one is why a coach will lose their hair. No matter...
Score! Two straight goals.
Gibson's made a textbook stop here. He's in good shape positionally. He makes the save, and he makes it look really easy.
The Panthers have broken the tie here in the third period. A wonderful ride to the finish for all of us now. The Ducks control from the faceoff. And the pickup. Anaheim's on the move, hoping to wheel it up the wing. To Huberdeau. Pass attempt to Barkov. Takes it in from the neutral zone. Score! Three in a row!
Square in the middle of his stick. Great technique.
And so sometimes your best isn't enough. That is a perfect shot up over the glove hand. The goaltender just was not able to get to it.
Florida's lead is now two. Here in the third period, they have to brace themselves for an attack. Good reach there. Intercepts that pass.
Florida's forced another turnover in this very close game.
Nice tip of the pass. Gains the zone. Chip to Kasha. Great poke check. Got it right back.
Good slapper, boys. Good slapper.
And angled to Matheson. Gathered up again by Hoffman. Brings a shot. Didn't have time, but he saved it anyway.
He's locked in now. Great save.
The Ducks lug that along through the neutral zone. Carried to the corner boards by Henrique.
Good nasty slapper, gentlemen.
Laid up that right side to Huberdeau. Scorches one. A terrific scoring chance denied. The Blue Jackets will be the last team to come through on this homestand. They are the next opponent before it ends.
big win. Let's see what happens.
And he's hit again. He'll feel that one tomorrow.
The Ducks have to take a chance here. They pull their goalie.
Propelled to Manson.
Wonderful save. Shoots. Terrific save there. Didn't look like he had anything to shoot at, and he made it tough.
He had his eye on the puck the whole time. What a stop.
The game is over. The Panthers have another win, and the streak continues.
With that win, Doc, they found themselves with a tidy streak intact. The wins just keep on coming.
So ends another game and another telecast. We hope you enjoyed this. Thanks for watching. For Eddie Olczyk and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich saying good night.
I can pay the price. That's 100 down from durability. That's bad. It's real bad. Defensive awareness should be working.
Everybody, along with Eddie Olczyk, Ray Ferraro is coming up. I'm Mike Emmerich. Tonight we get to see the top team in the league. Wonder what it's like to coach the best team.
Well, why wouldn't you, Doc? You certainly want to be standing behind that bench, but there are some challenges because you know the opposition is going to bring their best. They know that we're playing really well. They don't want to get embarrassed. I think the challenge is to continue to get the focus from your team, play the way that you have, but understand is that you're going to have to bring your work boots here tonight to have any chance of winning this game.
The Panthers coaching staff has prepared them extremely well. Regardless of the situation, they never change. If they're up a goal, down a goal, they stay with their same game plan and adjust accordingly. That's why they're on top of the league standings. And now we turn to the last lines of defense, the goalies.
coming off a victory, he gets the start tonight. Roberto Luongo, winner of several NHL honors, backstopped his team to a Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final, a draft choice of the New York Islanders over 20 years ago.
These really? Two teams are ready to play,
and we're ready to watch.
How old is the guy?
He's a good face-off man, ready for the Golden Knights. Barkov's out there to try to beat him for the Panthers. Got that pass in his own end.
His next goal will be a special one. He's got friends in the stands hoping to see it.
Fires! Wonderful save. What a skill level there.
That great save was all positioning.
Clock stop, so Ray can start.
Fleury's play this season has been so consistent. He's got an excellent win-loss record. He doesn't give up the bad goal when it's a crippling time for a team. He makes the big save when he has to. And as a result, the penalty killing's been really good, and they have enough confidence to be aggressive offensively to put enough numbers up on the board.
Thanks very much, Ray.
Florida's had the last 10 games to be admired. They've been physical, they've been aggressive, their power play has been exceptional, but they're going to get no break tonight because their opponent has been every bit as good in those areas in their 10-game segment.
Now it's directed to Huberdeau, looking to Dundas. Good grab again. Scooped up by Miller. Vegas charges up the wing. Trying to go to Dundas. Leads that charge into the zone. Save. And freezes play for the whistle. Over 4 minutes skated here in the first. Nothing on the scoreboard has changed. Still a pair of zeros.
Mascherani.
Vegas can really skate, Doc, and that's been a feature of their 10-game performance here, where they've played very well. Now, their opponent is an excellent skating team as well. We'll see who can impose their speed on the other.
Robbery there. And decides to just cover it up and get the whistle. Won that draw. A shot. Outstanding save with a glove. Face-off win here. A rocket. They score. It's his first ever goal, though he had to wait a while for it.
From in front than to chase the game. There's the game's first goal.
Some shots, only one goal.
A lot of opportunities. Love the mindset of getting pucks and people to the net.
The Golden Knights with a center ice faceoff win. Paula's tripped up. That should be a penalty. Florida's got two on this one for tripping.
I'm going to give credit to the puck carrier here. He kept his legs moving. He forced the back checker to reach in and take him off his feet.
The Golden Knights are activating their power play unit for the first time.
You can turn the tide of a game on a power play, whether you score or not, by getting shots, by getting traffic, and by keeping the puck in the offensive zone. If you chase it up and down the ice all the time, nothing gets accomplished.
The Golden Knights will send out their power play unit for the first time.
Michael Matheson, 2 minutes for delay.
Dundas carried it through the middle. He is able to move on in. The power play unit has to recoil and try yet again. Shoots one. Wonderful stop.
Over 8 minutes to go in period one. The Panthers lead 1-0. Good job on the draw. Gathered up again by Aiken.
Plotting strategy from behind. A big one-timer.
Save there. Gets a little drop off from the goalie here.
Steps in from the neutral zone. Right in that catching glove. Good work.
Pass attempt to Smith. Shoots one. Oh, a save there.
A solid job with the pads. Play halted.
Dundas doesn't turn away from too many hits. As a result, he has among the highest hit totals in the league. He generates offense by separating body from puck.
Florida's killed off a penalty, and so we're back at full strength.
Sometimes you need a pop, sometimes you need a puck bounce, or you need a little bit of puck luck. They didn't get any of it on that power play, and they come back to even strength in the same position that they were when they entered the power play, down one.
Shoots one. At least he protected his goaltender.
To Smith.
Gains the zone. Fires. Terrific save there. Didn't look like he had anything to shoot at, and he made it tough.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
He's got that one measured in the attacking zone. Drives the line. Shoots. Great save. Presses that attack. Feeds it in front. Blocked. Picked up by the defense. Can start the attack going in the zone. And a save. Elevator to Huberdeau. Great save.
Oh, I'm big hit. I'm big hit.
20 minutes are in the books, and so the coaches will have their say.
Oops.
The players will rest and listen. The Panthers have the only goal.
Just a friendly reminder about tonight's time of hockey.
Girardi's goal has put his team ahead, for at least now. Will it stand up? We go to break. The zone and looks over his options. And at an angle to Ekblad.
Tremendous hit. Oh, he's been looking for that hit all night.
Well, that's
back to the point. Chip to Miller. Just walking the tightrope. Propelled to Theodore. Shot on. Recollected. He was standing in the lane and got some up. Skates out with it. Puck picked off. Padded away. Back to the blue line. To the front. Takes it right back. Superb save by Luongo. Collected now. Poke check. Florida's up the wing setting things up.
Idiot.
What's his next move from behind? Shoots. Say. Passing one off now to Tuck. Gains that offensive line. Got it at the point.
Hey, Pacini. Zapek. Nobody tell me Zapek.
That face-off from the tie-up, the help came. Whistle blown because the puck had gone into the player's bench area.
It's pretty cool how excited people get for a four-ounce chunk of rubber. But getting a game puck is exciting. The funny part is the players are around these things all the time and it doesn't mean anything to them, so they just flip it up over the glass.
Florida's seeing the penalty clock bleeding down to the last few seconds. Florida's power play did not do it for them.
Once in a while, an ugly goal is one that will get you going a little bit, but if you pass a puck around the outside looking for that perfect play, chances are it's not going to happen. That was a great example.
Feeds the point. Cranks one. Oh, he got in the way of that one. It's blocked.
Dangerous looking shift here. They need to get the puck to the net and get some net front presence.
Outstanding body contact.
Ooh, that one's gonna hurt.
He got the outside of the post.
Oh, just a few inches from being a perfectly placed shot.
I
don't think the puck here ever thought that this player was gonna come in and make this big, huge hit.
Fuck's sake. Fuck's sake, joysticks. I almost got a fucker in, but... Oh, a couple of joysticks.
Gathered up again by Pacioretty. Florida's in the neutral zone along the wing. Let's it go. A strong pant stop there. That puck hit him on the way to the net. Smart recovery. Alone! No!
Well, there wasn't a lot to shoot at. The goaltender had good positioning.
Grab that pass in the neutral zone. Outlet up the middle to Aiken. Two guys together with force. Big force.
Pacioretty's going to have to gather himself after taking that hit solidly. He was not aware where everybody was. Dundas found the spot where he had his opponent in a vulnerable spot. Clean hit.
Terrific job at the faceoff circle today. Just like that. Fires one. What a tremendous hit. Well, they got to be a little tired after these first two periods of play.
Close bachelor. Close bachelor, boys.
Toward period number
close
three.
Fuckery.
As is our custom, we look now at the shots on goal. Wow, does anybody play defense here? 20 for Vegas and 19 for Florida. Third period.
Close bachelor.
The rear view mirror will help us with the first two, and so will Edson.
Vegas is down in this game, Doc, but they can easily be ahead. Why? Their time of possession. They've had the puck a lot in this game. All they need now is to finish off some of those chances.
Miller's tripped, and a penalty should be coming. Florida sent to the box for 2 minutes. It's tripping.
This power play is too predictable. They have to find a way to change it up.
Eddie, I'm with you on that. Power play beginning.
They didn't take advantage on the power play earlier in the game. Let's see if they can jump on the board here.
Huge hit. Possession's gone.
You go through that area of the ice, there's a pretty good chance you're going to get hit.
He throws it there. That puck was obstructed by a screen. The Panthers shoot it back out. Got some time to check the clock and prepare to defend again. Moving it to Pacioretty. Receives that pass from the other side. What a terrific save. Rips one. What a save. I was looking for the light to come on. Great defense. Got to clear it. It's dumped in. They must retreat and start back again. Carries it on in from center. Shoots. Wonderful work in close and a brilliant save.
Fantastic setup and equally great stop by the goaltender.
And he dumps it in.
Yeah.
It's on his tape. What a marvelous pass through the center of the ice. Shoots it on. Wonderful stop. Directing that one to Barkov. Slid to Dundas. He scores! That's an answer goal.
You fight so long in a tied game. Now you've got the game-breaking goal. What do you do with it? I think you attack. You try to get another one. Or at the very least, you don't let your opponent breathe.
The Panthers have gotten a one-goal lead here in the third period. Do they go for two, or do they just try to protect this? And they won the neutral zone faceoff. You win that, and you don't have to chase. They chase you.
Very important steal for him.
Pitching this one to Huberdeau.
Sends to the point. Shoots. Save there.
Hangs on to that one, and he'll see a faceoff right near him.
Florida's offense circles around one of the highest goal scorers in the league. While he can score off the rush, his most dangerous weapon is that quick release. The Panthers do an excellent job limiting their opponent's shots on net. One of the main reasons is how many shots they block. Over the last few games, it's a crazy number.
And a save. Almost an ill-advised pass from the goalie. Crosses that line. Right to the point.
Don't get goal in, please.
Pitching it to Aiken. Snapping a pass to Smith. Shoots one.
Great save. And decides to just hold on and get a stoppage of play.
Pittsburgh's not a team to be taken lightly, Doc. They're up next on the schedule, and of course, we'll be calling all the action. Some great, exciting hockey games ahead.
Yeah, Pucha. Puch.
Good clean win. Let's it go. Save! A little under 8 minutes still showing on the clock this period. Once we were tied. Maybe we'll be tied again. That faceoff is won. Turned a shot on net. He got his glove on that one.
This game is going to wind down and be close right to the final horn.
Hits the post and out. May not have intended it, but it hit it.
He's got no hip pocket. It's a good thing. He just got swiped.
Florida's been an offensive juggernaut led by this player who has among the highest points totals in the league. He's a dangerous player, remarkably skilled on the power play.
Puck dropped and the winger stepped in to help. That's big.
Laid on to Pizik. Florida's looking to head man up the wing. Good job, he rubbed him right out.
Great play along the boards. Tries to wear down his man by throwing the body.
Oh, broke it up.
Solid work there by Huberdeau.
Florida's along the wing at center ice.
Gathered up again by Pacioretty. Puck is thrown to Holla. Fantastic poke check by Yandel. The Panthers setting things up in their own end.
Oh, what a hit that one was!
This just continues what he's done throughout the previous part of the game. He's been on the body from the very beginning. Now he's trying to spark his team as they need to come back to get themselves into
the game. I'm paying the prize again!
Because this team is really executing effectively on their game. That's another win, and the streak continues.
Some nights are special in memory. This one was an outstanding game. So long for now.
You're 75, you're paying the price. Discipline up. We got a bunch of shots blocked. Bunches of defensive awareness. Qué pucho. Che pucho.
Hello, everyone. Along with Eddie Olchek, Ray Ferraro in a moment, I'm Mike Emmerich, and tonight we are going to see a man on the ice that leads the league in hits. The opposition team know about him.
Absolutely. He's circled in the pregame scouting report, knowing that that particular player likes to finish his checks, likes to play physical. Well, the way you beat that, Doc, is move the puck quickly. Don't allow him to get in on the forecheck and look to run you into the third or fourth row.
Doug Ness is the guy we were talking about. He has the ability to change the momentum in a hockey game due to his physical style of play. You will see and hear him tonight. We direct our attention to the Nets and the starting goalies. Won the last one, so he starts this one. Rask's the last line of defense for the Bruins. The winning percentage is pretty strong as human beings holding all of that equipment go. He's just fine. About to begin, Thomas Vanek is waiting for the draw. Austrian-born won an NCAA title in overtime with the game winner for Minnesota. You are here at the right moment with Eddie Olchek and Ray Ferraro, Mike Emmerich, and play is just underway.
The Panthers fans are thrilled with the show this team has been putting on in this extended stretch of wins. Overconfidence might be their only enemy.
Wonderful stop. He is slashed, and there'll be a penalty for that. Florida's got a two-minute minor for slashing. The Bruins are activating their power play unit for the first time.
This is a power play earned in a scoreless game. Their power play can now get them on the board and give them a lead.
Under the penalty, 1 minute, 33 seconds.
Puck dropped in the log jam, and the winger reached in and got it. Florida's cleared. A lot of work, but penalty time less and less now. To Marchand. Is able to move on in. Shoot. Save there. Directed on. Stick save on the changing shot. Pulls the trigger. And ring more bells on that one. One after another.
I missed the big hit there.
The second save was better.
That was nasty. I missed the big hitter.
No goals to report yet.
Kind of nasty, huh?
Gives it to the point. That punt was obstructed by a screen. On to Krejci. Sends to the point. Slid to Pastrnak. Let's it go. Save. They've got all the gunners out. Dishes it back. Big shot from the point. Oh, that's a great save by Luongo. Directing that one to Barkov.
Good. Give me.
Snaps one. May not have been intentional, but he got it anyway. Stands him up.
What a bitchery, man. What a bitchery. What a nasty skunkers.
Snapping a pass to Hyman. Broke that play up at center. Now it's directed to Dundas.
Look out, the hits are coming.
Dundas always has a target on him, and he got absolutely train wrecked. He was not aware of who was around him, and he took the hit solidly.
Puts one on. The pad flashed out to turn that aside. Huge hit in open ice.
That's why coaches tell you at every level, you got to have your head up.
Went to the backhand. Save! The Bruins are driving it from the wing. Pitching it to Grizzly. Brings it in for an attack. The clock has bled down to the last minute.
Clockers.
First period is in the books. Perfection on the part of defense and goaltending. Challenges ahead for the offense when we get to the second.
Hey fans, don't forget to enter tonight for our team.
Second period about to begin here. Let's take a look back at the first. What stuck out for you?
Boston's coaching staff told us, Doc, before the game that they wanted to get off to a good start, and they did, but they can't get discouraged without scoring a goal in that first period.
Second period is underway, and neither team has scored yet. That puck struck him in front. To Dundas. Carried right up the middle. In the slot. That's terrific goaltending.
Fantastic setup and equally great stop by the goaltender.
Let's it go. What a save. I was looking for the light to come on. Oh, what a hit that one was.
I wonder if that hit will change the momentum of this game.
Florida's in the neutral zone along the way. Right in front. Outstanding save. What magic even to get there and get the shot off. Great opportunity, but the pass didn't connect. A delayed penalty call is signaled. Soccered along by Thomas Vanek. Florida's getting a minor penalty here for interference.
Clearly an interference call, not allowing the player to get involved into the play.
Time of the penalty. Boston's power play gets another chance to operate. Hasn't been effective yet.
Well, their power play hasn't come through for them yet. Here's another opportunity. See if they can take advantage of it.
Cleared it back out of there. The Bruins, wow, what a hit. What a mean-spirited hit. They'll be taken to task for that one. Nice work by Krejci. Quick wrist shot. The lane was jammed, and it hit somebody. The Panthers shoot it back out. Got some time to check the clock and prepare to defend again. Takes it in from the neutral zone. With a shot. He takes that point pass. Padded away. They're getting all organized now. Oh, he got in the way of that one. It's blocked. Heaves one. A strong pad stop there. And the penalty killers come up big again. It's clear. Boston's back in its own end, trying to work forward. Stolen at center ice. Gains that offensive line. Lets it go. Great save. Boston's hoarding the puck at mid-ice. A one-timer, a shot, stop!
God, fuck.
And that is goal number 200 in his career.
200 God, goals. It's a select company, Doc. I love how this player scores goals.
The Panthers win the draw. What's next? Ahead on that left wing to Dundas.
Assisted by number 74, Jake DeBrun.
Using the point.
I should just rest it.
The neutral zone controlling play now.
Yeah, we don't have chances.
Fires. That's a good
save. Debauchery.
They're going to have to come up with something better than that. And on top of that, another great stop.
These saves are all about positioning.
Boston's taking advantage of the delayed call. The goalie is off. Oh, terrific save on a great chance.
Yeah, they're playing on the power play. The game is toasted. Game is toasted.
9:20. Florida special teams will have their first chance of the game.
Well, you get your power play on the ice for the first time, you can really generate some momentum whether you score or not. Have a positive power play.
Great work with the stick. Chewed up more time in that penalty kill by getting rid of it there. No team worth its name is going to let that go. So, as predicted, we have a fight here.
All players have a role, Doc. Two things, accept and execute. And he certainly did that.
Five minutes apiece for fighting. The way they went, they should have gotten 10.
Florida's going to try and grab some momentum from this bout. They clearly are the victors. While that was an energetic fight, the home team wins it. Now they'll see if they can turn the crowd back on. This is the loudest this building's been all night.
Just under 5 minutes to go in the second. It's a 1-0 game. Two periods have been played in our game. A lot of goals have been scored, and maybe even more coming up in the third. Third period about to begin. The rearview mirror will help us with the first two, and so will Edzo.
The Bruins have to be happy, Doc, that they're up by one as we get ready for the third period, but they have to be frustrated with all the chances that they had in the first two periods of play.
Boston's in a nail-biter here after two, 1-0. Left wing pass to Marchand.
Driving in from no man's land.
Carried to the corner boards by Bergeron.
A collision.
Pass cut by the offense. And down to DeBrusque. Gives it over to the point. Lets it go. Save. Right on his stick. Can he get it out? Couldn't clear it out. Gathered up again by Patrice Bergeron. Really solid possession and pressure. Not done yet, though.
Presses that attack.
Passing one off now to Hoffman.
In with it now.
Turned a shot on net. And a save. Held there for a face-off coming up next.
Shit. What a bachelor, what a bachelor, man. What a fucking game.
The Panthers win it.
That puck left the zone, and so everybody has to drop back to center.
Pitching this one to Pastrnak.
Took that pass perfectly off the wing.
Trying to go to DeBrusque.
Punched away. Tremendous hit.
Dundas finishes that check solidly, and the bench is excited about it. When a skilled guy gets involved physically, it really stirs everybody up.
Steps across that line.
What a bachelor game.
Boston's power play is set up.
What a bachelor, man.
Options for them.
Fucking
that really
fuckers.
Makes them difficult to contend with. As a result, they're among the league's very best.
Absolutely, Ray. Let's see if they keep you a wise man.
Cut that pass in his own end.
The Bruins would love to take this shutout all the way to the finish. Their goaltender has been amazing, and they want to protect him as much as they can.
Locks on that to Pastrnak. At an angle to McAvoy.
Centers it. Plump save. Nice.
Snaps it to Krug. To Marchand. Boston's power play not as good this time as before.
Well, that last power play wasn't very good, guys. Earlier in the game, they were pretty zoned in. They moved the puck well, and they were able to cash in. But this last one is why a coach will lose their hair. No matter what you draw up on the board, it has to be executed, and that one wasn't.
Nice face-off work. Laid on to Dundas.
Cranks the blast.
Smart recovery by Vanek.
You set or create momentum by your ability to either handle the puck or by your ability to lay the body on. His isn't a skill game. Right now, tonight, he's been among the most physical players.
Looking to Dundas.
Get out.
Carries it on in from center.
Chip to Barkov.
May not have intended it, but it hit it.
Drill. He missed the net.
I think with him getting bounced around in a slot area, he just got a little discombobulated and missed the net completely.
Pass attempt to Hyman. A good stick there, so no complete pass.
Yeah, a little bit fucky game. We got nothing from it.
And the game is over. And that's the end of this one. The game has ended. The Panthers have seen their long winning streak.
Leg of offense.
They came in this one flying.
I guess.
Despite a close battle, they come out the losers. Time to regroup.
Well, we were defending most of the time, so what offense are you speaking about? If you are defending the whole game, you can't attack. It's that simple.
Ray Ferraro in just a moment, and I'm Mike Emmerich, and we are tonight seeing a team that is on a bit of a downside. They have not been able to win consistently lately. Take us inside that locker room. What's it like?
Well, you got to try to find some confidence, Doc, right now, because you are shaken. The pressure is on you. Your fans are on you. The media is on you. Your coach is probably all over you. But I think more than anything else, it's a mindset. Is let's not really try to worry about winning the game, because that is the end result, and we know that. But let's win the first period and see where we are after the first period of play.
Tampa Bay's found themselves on a losing streak as of late, but they have been doing some good things. It's just a matter of time before they are rewarded for all their hard work. Maybe it's tonight. Okay, so let's look at the starting goaltenders for the game. He gets the nod in goal tonight despite a loss in the last game. Reimer's the last line of defense for the Panthers. See that goals against average? He's right in there. Very solid. Steven Stamkos. His 60 goals at age 22 won him the Rocket Richard Trophy. He'll shoot your lights out on the power play. Over a third of his goals come that way. Fires. Oh, what a save that was. Collected by Erik Karlsson. Big hit there. These two teams have that reputation. I'll bet some more are coming. Rister, score! Off the iron and in!
Yeah, it's Reimer in the goal.
Well, the key, once you score one, try and get another. Push them back on their heels.
Well, of course, it's Reimer in the goalie.
Hope if you're paying the price of admission as a home fan,
Reimer in the goal
scores first. In this case, it has.
So far, they got their money's worth early in this game.
Many yards gained to Matheson. Sends to the point. Say. Nice work by Hedman. Snapping a pass to Kucherov. Oh, what a mean hit that one was. That's probably going to bring an answer. And so, if the penalty box door's ready, the gloves are off. This fight is over. What a way to finish it.
It is much better to give than receive. Trust me. Those guys have been eyeing themselves up all night long. They're going to get a chance to look at each other from the penalty box for 5 minutes.
A little over 3 minutes skated here in the first. Tampa Bay's got the lead, 1-0. It's dropped. They lock up, and that's a good job by the wingers.
3 minutes, 6 seconds.
With a pace like this, you know the game will stay open. If there's no whistles, as there hasn't been, the game will open up and there'll be more chances as we go along.
Perfect passing right through center. Good place to shoot from, and he does. Somehow, this one's going to come free. In their own end, pressing onward. Carries it on in from center. Lets it go. Oh, and it's off the mark.
When the puck sounds hard, when it hits the end boards, that means you've missed the net. Scoring chances handed away.
Fires. Save. Laid on to Malkin. A superb hit. A great hockey play there.
He's trying to wake his team up with that hit.
Shoots. Big glove save. And the whistle on that stop will halt the play.
There are a few ways to stop the momentum against you. That's one way. Cover up and reset.
Tampa Bay's been blocking shots over the last few games at a crazy rate. Their players lie down to block shots. They get into the shooting lanes to block them standing up. This is something they work on pretty consistently in practice.
Directing that one to Barkov. Puck is thrown to Yandel. Driving in from no man's land. Puck ricocheted off the screen. Trying to go to Pizik. Back and forth they go between the points. Good save. It's going to have to be something tougher than that to score.
Florida's physical play opens up the ice for them all over the place. This player has among the highest hit totals in the league. Very valuable, although he's not a big scorer.
Fuck.
Trying to clear the zone. Period one is in the books. Both teams scored one time. The goalies dominated the rest of the time. We'll see if that continues when the second period gets started. Tampa Bay's hanging into this game largely on the strength of the man between the pipes. Here is just one of his many saves in that period. We'll be right back. All even up as the second period begins. Slid to Dundas. He wore that puck on a hard shot. Gathered up again by Miller. He gains the zone. Gathered up by Stamkos. Strong wrister. Save. Passing one off now to Huberdeau. On to Dundas. Scorches one. He was standing in the lane and got some of it.
Carlson's nicked up here. Guys, he's going to have to finish his shift. They're stuck in their own zone.
Chip to Miller. To Killorn. Tampa Bay's along the wing at center ice. One-timer, a magnificent pad save. The Panthers setting things up in their own end. And the whistle signals an offside.
Really easy stop for the goaltender. Down to the butterfly, he's able to control that shot.
Just over 6 minutes left to go. Scrappy game, both of these teams have connected once. Gates it into the zone. A great wrist shot. Save. Skilled play by Steven Stamkos. Pass. Outstanding save. Difficult opportunity.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
And a save. Gets a little drop off from the goalie here. And he steps across the line. He's got that point pass. Great save. Great poke check. Wow, what a hit. What a mean-spirited hit. He'll be taken to task for that one. And the end result of what's happened is this. The gloves are down.
It's not about winning or losing the fight. It's about showing up. And he did in a big way.
these two teams get together, you can expect the game to run a little hot. Both of these guys feel the heat.
And this fight has ended with one last solid punch.
Great hands for not only scoring, but also knocking out his opponent.
Miller's headed directly down the tunnel after that fight. He's not going to the penalty box. He's going to go get some physical attention.
Tampa Bay penalty to number 10, JT Miller. A 5-minute major for fighting.
Third period will be coming up shortly, but two great periods have been played. The offenses have been held to just one goal apiece. And here's Ray.
Carlson's been missing from the bench for quite some time. I just got word now he won't be back today.
Across that line. A collision.
Oh, that is a great hit. I love that hit. In the open ice, you really send a message with one of those.
Propelled to Ernie. That one is pointed to him. Right along the line. Smart recovery by Huberdeau. The Panthers look to make a difference up the wing. Shoots. Oh, deflected away. Tampa Bay skating in their own end, trying to get to the neutral zone. Pitching this one to Hayes. And he is reefed.
Dundas often leads with his skill. A tremendously talented player, but man, when he lays the body on, the bench jumps to its feet.
Hammers one. That's a great glove save. Didn't miss by much.
You have to give yourself a chance here. You cannot blow this puck past the net.
Hammers one. Terrific opportunity, but it would not go. He missed the net.
Fuck.
Let's it go. They score.
That was unfortunate, Pucker. That was unfortunate, Pucker.
Now, if they can win this faceoff and fire off another
fucking Reimer. It's only you, Reimer. It's on you.
You get to Stamkos.
You fuck.
Kucherov steps in from the neutral zone. Has that point pass as well. Great pad stop.
It's on you, Reimer, you fucker.
That one for a stoppage in play.
It's one of the most grueling calendars in all of professional sports, Doc. Players are playing
through. It's on you, Reimer. You suck.
Travel, but the best teams
you suck, Reimer.
Lots of
you fucking suck.
For us over the next little stretch.
A point blast. That puck struck him in front. A shot. A terrific scoring chance denied. Puck loose. Couldn't get through. He's got him against the glass. Snaps it to Stamkos. Point blank shot.
That was
a marvelous save.
Fantastic setup and equally great stop by the goaltender.
Shoots one. Made that work for him in goal. Play stopped. That puck is just held.
You can't deliver the puck much better than that, but the goalie said no chance. That's an excellent save.
They won it. Now what can they do? Good, solid defense there. Gains the zone. Fires, swept aside.
It's almost like these teams are mirror images of each other. There's no room on the ice. Nobody has been able to spread out the play and generate a whole ton of scoring chances.
Tampa Bay is along the wing at center ice. Shoots. Wonderful save. Pass attempt to Dundas.
This just continues what he's done throughout the previous part of the game. He's been on the body from the very beginning. Now he's trying to spark his team as they need to come back to get themselves into the game.
No.
The clock is at zeros. The game is over. Tampa Bay's losing streak has continued. Another disappointing finish tonight. that's it for another great night at a hockey rink. For Eddie and Ray, Doc saying good evening, everyone.
Los Angeles Kings. Now we are playing versus Biggies. Good, we are playing versus Big guys. That's great.
Focus, because when a team gets out on the road and they know they're going to be going home relatively soon, it's hard not to have the mind start to wander. So for me, really, the mental preparation for this game here tonight, especially in the first period, can really make the decision whether this is an outstanding trip or an average trip. The Kings are a veteran team. We've seen this scenario before. We have made mention of the mental side of the game at the end of a long road trip, but they have to show up physically as well. And I'm not just talking about the hitting part of the game. I'm talking skating, passing, shooting, doing all the things you need to do to win a game at the end of a long road trip.
We direct our attention to the Nets and the starting goalies. Roberto Luongo, winner of several NHL honors, backstopped his team to a Game 7 of the Stanley Cup Final, a draft choice of the New York Islanders over 20 years ago. Coming off a victory, he gets the start tonight. Two teams chomping at the bit. Let's get going. Barkov's the starting center for the Panthers. Kopitar's there for Los Angeles. The Panthers have the first possession of the game.
Florida's hard work in their last game paid off as they added another plus to the win column. Stick to the plan tonight and you will be rewarded.
Dogged determination there by Kopitar. And he steps in. Perfect, Krister. He got in the lane of the shot and blocked it. Shot on. Great save. Down near the players is Ray Ferraro.
Luongo's had an excellent season so far. He's got a high winning percentage, way more wins than losses. He's made enough saves that gives his team a chance to get their feet underneath them when they don't play very well. But he's been pretty consistent this year. We'll see if the opposition can get somebody in his eyes tonight, make it difficult for him to see the puck.
Okay, Ray, thank you. And at an angle, to Toffoli. Rister, score! LA's ahead by one goal here in the first period. A lot of time still left to play, but getting one and breaking the tie was huge.
Panthers are only half of the group in this game that has played very well over the last 10 games. Both of these teams have played almost identically. Their records are almost identical as they head into this matchup.
Scooped up by Kopitar. Read that play at his own end. Puts one on. A shot that went way off the mark.
This was a heavy shot, but it had no chance of going in because it missed the net.
Has it picked up. In with it now. From the outside. He scores! Two straight goals!
Back and forth here in a tie game. Now they've got the lead. We'll see what they do with it.
Florida's gone up by one now. The difference in shots on goal is not even close to one. The Panthers control from the faceoff. Into the attacking end. Hutton quickly back. Swept on to Matheson. What a tremendous hit.
Dundas didn't have anywhere to go, and he got smoked. His team is not very happy about this.
On the outside, a shot. Save. Directing that one to Barkov. Looking to Huberdeau. Gains the blue line. And down to Barkov. Terrific determination by Huberdeau. Hangs on to that one, and he'll see a faceoff right here.
Florida's offense circles around one of the highest goal scorers in the league. While he can score off the rush, his most dangerous weapon is that quick release.
The Panthers win it. Somebody straight across. Puck has to be first. Offside. We take time out every once in a while to celebrate a milestone, and that has been done earlier. Eddie, your thoughts on 1,000 games.
They reward players that play 1,000 games in this league with a special gift. I can relate. They gave him the silver stick prior to the game in a great ceremony.
Florida's in their own end and controlling play now. Nearing the final minute of play. Crosses that line. Stole that pass at a critical end of the ice. Hammers one. Oh, a save there. And he holds on and stops play.
Quick's going to be able to make that save all day. His positioning is perfect. It's not a difficult scoring chance.
LA's prevailed on another faceoff. Thought open ice hitting was gone.
If you can catch somebody unawares in the middle of the ice, you know that you were really giving them a solid wallop. That was a great hit.
Good shooting place. Save there. First period is finished. Both teams scored, but there is a lead to carry into the locker room. The Panthers have an advantage of one.
Hey fans, don't forget to find those draw boxes throughout the arena for our signed jersey, which we will give away tonight.
Minutes in the books, 20 minutes ahead. And so what did you think of the first?
Los Angeles trails in this game, and one noteworthy stat is their time with the puck. They haven't had it much since the opening faceoff, and they'll want to get more time on attack in order to score more goals.
Outstanding body contact.
I wonder if that hit will change the momentum of this game.
Puck fired down, decision made. Defenders first, icing.
Florida's been an offensive juggernaut, led by this player who has among the highest points totals in the league. He's a dangerous player, remarkably skilled on the power play.
The Kings prevail again. Gives it over to the point.
skill play by Kopitar. Feeds the point. Big drive. Puck controlled now by the defense. Pass attempt to Huberdeau. Nice work by Doughty.
Somebody got in early, and so offside is called.
Florida's physical play opens up the ice for them all over the place. This player has among the highest hit totals in the league. Very valuable, although he's not a big scorer.
A face-off win. Let's see what develops. Got it at the point.
Drives it. The lane was jammed, and it hit somebody. Brings it in for an attack.
Lets it go.
Wonderful chance to score, but no.
A little under 4 minutes are gone here in the second. And it is 2-1, the score in this one. They won that draw. Oh, what a chance, what a save. And he dumps it in. Smart recovery by Doughty. Two guys together with force, big force.
Dundas finishes that check solidly, and the bench is excited about it. When a skilled guy gets involved physically, it really stirs everybody up.
Shoots, directed to the net. Outstanding glove on a shot that changed direction.
Wow, this looked like it was going in for sure, but he was able to make the save on that puck that changed directions.
Puck dropped in the log jam, and the winger reached in and got it.
Cleared out, and that forces them to drop back. The Panthers prevail on the draw. That's a good solid hit. He'll feel that one.
Oh, that's going to make them think twice about going to that area.
And a save.
You don't see this from these two teams a lot, pushing and shoving after whistles, but keep an eye on it.
Dundas is such a reliable player. His coaches use him in every important situation. He has among the highest plus-minus totals in the league, and that justifies the confidence the coach shows in him.
But a good reach and a good step in there for possession. The Kings with a clean win on the draw.
He got rid of it.
Passing one off now to Ekblad. Now it's directed to Dundas.
Big drive! He wore that puck on a hard shot. Cleared back out again, and so the power play unit has to drop back.
Gathered up again by Yandel. Backhander to the net.
May not have intended it, but it hit it. He cleared that puck out of there.
Power play time is continuing to wind. Way back, it's taken by Yandel.
Scorches one. Save! They worked hard, and they got it back out. Good job of penalty killing here by Los Angeles. Bangs it ahead to Dundas. Cut that pass in his own end. Leads that charge into the zone. Holds in the corner. Wouldn't let him block.
Florida's in control of the puck in their own end.
Let's the shot fly. Save. And holds on to that puck to get the whistle.
Every once in a while, you get enough time to deliver a slap shot. You can really lean into it. he was able to make the save then.
Fuck. Now they got power play. What a bitchers. What a bitchers.
The Kings win that faceoff.
Chip to Pearson.
What a score! Extra man, extra goal.
The Kings have fought their way back into this, getting it tied before the end of the second period. Coach's words in the intermission, and an exciting third lies ahead. He's got it.
Los Angeles. Fuck's sake.
It up the wing.
By number 70, Tanner Pearson. And by number 3,
he takes that point pass. Florida's back in its own end, trying to work forward.
What a ripper!
Oh, he get it. Holy shit. That was a good fucker. Fuck's sake, he get it. Unbelievable.
Under 3 minutes to go in the second.
That was a good end.
Goals apiece.
Really good try.
Florida's got that faceoff win. Let's it go. Oh, he had a great chance to shoot there, and he did, but it was answered by the glove. Oh, and he is drilled.
I once had a coach tell me, hit or be hit. There's an example of getting yourself into the game.
Paddled aside. Back to the point. On to Dundas. That puck struck him in front. Wow,
holy boy.
Does he have enough gas? The pad came in handy that time. Gains the zone. That is up close and personal. Gathered up again by Huberdeau. Stole that pass away in his own end.
Fuck's sake.
40 minutes have been played here and still more to go. A well-deserved rest is at hand. Let's take a look at the two-period shots on goal totals. They are 23 for the Panthers and 17 for Los Angeles. We have begun period 3 and knotted up on the scoreboard. Puck grab, they're ready to go. Sends to the point. Hatchet's one. Pitching it to Huberdeau. Steps across that line. Let's it go. Puck ricocheted off the screen. Here's a one-timer. Outstanding save there.
There's been a number of close chances here at either end as this continued tie game strung out. Now they've got the lead. We'll see where it takes us now.
The Panthers have broken the tie here in the third period. So what will be their philosophy now? We'll probably see it from this opening faceoff. Los Angeles carries it through the neutral zone. Long lead pass to Muzzin. Gathered up again by Kopitar. Muscled right off it. It's one of those restraining fouls. It's a hooking penalty. And the arm of the referee is up. And play is stopped for a penalty. Florida's two-minute penalty is a minor, and the call is hooking. The Kings go on the power play again. They have connected once already.
They've already had some success on the power play with it.
Score! It's another power play goal. A little over 4 minutes have been skated in the third.
This is pathetic.
The winds have shifted yet again.
This is really, really fucking pathetic.
Two goals so far, Rockies out there vying for the third one to give them the hat trick.
Laid on to Kopitar.
Yeah, penalties are power plays are killing us.
Terrific determination by Huberdeau. Nicely into the zone.
A rocket dings it off the iron.
Wrister from the slot. Sticked away. Right, here's a long pass, and it's...
Power plays are killing us.
Tries to get it on net. Save. Barkov's tripped up. That should be a penalty.
They really are.
Fires. Great save. Outstanding save by the goalie.
Amazing reaction.
And we get another penalty. The referee goes to the penalty timekeeper.
Well, the referees are doing a good job, Doc, here. They're huddling up. They're talking. They're getting communicating. They're trying to figure out exactly what the calls on the ice should be.
Every game presents a fork-in-the-road opportunity, and this is it. It's a long 5-on-3 power play, and it begins now. Score!
Shoot it and get traffic to the front of the net. Now they've got a one-goal lead.
Florida's broken the tie here in the third period. Let's see what happens before time expires.
This is an easy game to comment on because it's been nothing but goals.
Okay, we're done. They're done.
There's not been many saves to talk about. The goaltenders have had a difficult night defensively. They haven't had much help either, as both teams are filling the net.
The Kings have it along the side at mid-ice. Turn the wrist shot. Oh, what a save. He brought his best shot, and it got stopped. Shoots it off. Did what he's paid to do. Pitching this one to Ponick. Can start the attack going in the zone. Great save. Puck covered, whistle blown. Los Angeles will be finding that this is the time of the year that a lot of families come to visit them because it's a long stretch at home. Good time for socializing and a great time for stringing together some victories. That's a solid face-off win. Score! Another step in the road back. They're down by two.
Quick hands allowed him to snap that one off and score the goal.
Luongo's a goaltender that can be beaten up over the shoulders. He closes down the bottom of the net, Edzo, but this time they beat him up over his shoulders right near the elbow.
LA's goal gets them to within two. There is still time, thus there is still hope. It's a good thing. The Kings with a center ice faceoff win.
By number 14, Richard Panning.
Propelled to Kempe. Terrific challenge. Outstanding save.
The shooter thought he had a chance, but the goaltender robs him. What a stop.
And he steps across the line.
From the slot, Wrister.
Got a piece of that one. We are in the last minute.
That's how you break up a play.
Into the end of attack.
A howitzer. Oh, he got it. You couldn't have chosen a better guy for that shot, or apparently a better guy to stop it. Horn sounds, game over. The Panthers record the victory in this one. Closer than it should have been, Doc. A lot of power play opportunities. Something to work on moving forward.
Terrific contest. Two teams gave their very best. See you next time.
What the big hits I got. Good amount, shot blocking is up. Basically. Yeah, two goals, six hits. Hoffman or Adorno. Hard bucker.
But they
Let's go.